I made 300 AI warriors fight each other after training them for more than 200 hours. The soldiers will have to learn all by themselves what the best strategy is to dominate their opponents, and at the end I will show how you can create your own simulations as well. The artificial intelligence agents will be separated into three teams: red, blue, and green, and will have to face different fight scenarios such as free-for-all, where all teams are enemies, alliance war, where two teams will be fighting together against a common foe, and so on. But before we get to the training, let me explain how this whole thing works. For this episode in particular, we'll only focus on one soldier type, the warrior. And that is an artistic choice, and definitely not the fact that I haven't implemented other classes yet. But more on this later. The warrior is a melee unit who, similar to office rats that hate remote work, necessarily needs to get close and personal first, and only then he can start working. And oh boy, does he work. With a single, well-placed swing of his sword, warriors can single-handedly eliminate an entire opponent squad. Yes, for this video, their attacks deal enough damage to one-shot their opponents, but we will change and optimize these values the more soldier types are added to the simulation. The sword attack has a cooldown of 1 second, and while swinging it, the warrior is at his most vulnerable, both against enemy blades, but especially against enemy wards. While there is no protection from the trash talk, warriors are able to defend themselves from physical attacks using their secondary ability, shield block. When the shield is raised, it will absorb all damage incoming from the front of the warrior while still leaving the back and sides exposed. Warriors are unable to move while their shield is up, and they will have to wait a cooldown of 5 seconds if they want to repeat the action. But as they always say, if they can't catch you, you won't catch a beating. So warriors have also been blessed with a decent move speed and health points, making them a good and versatile soldier, which, if trained properly, could become a real asset on the battlefield, ready to sacrifice his life and future just so we can have a few giggles here and there. Sounds like a fair trade to me. Talking about warriors training, the process is rather simple, so give me a few more seconds before we get to the fun part of torturing the AI. The agents are able to observe different information about themselves and environment, such as their stats like HP, move speed and damage, the cooldown times for the primary and secondary actions, as well as the current action they are performing, their local position and rotation in space, and so on. Similarly, an agent will have access to the same information about enemies and allies around him, hopefully resulting in some complex strategies such as counterattacking after successful blocking or grouping together to outnumber an enemy squad. At the beginning, all the actions the agents take are random and chaotic, and that is where the fun part begins. The AI will be rewarded every time it achieves something I deemed to be good, such as successfully blocking an enemy attack, landing a hit themselves, or minecrafting an opponent. But most importantly, the AI will also be punished for anything I consider to be a bad decision, such as missing their attacks, getting hit by an opponent, failing to leave, and my personal favorite, simply for existing. The agents will then slowly shape and change their behavior in attempts to minimize the punishment and maximize the reward, ensuring they are stripped of any glimmer of free will they might have had, making them the ideal soldiers. I mean, what could go wrong with an army of cold-blooded AI warriors whose only goal is eliminating others, right? Great, then let's get started with the training. Initially, I made all teams spawn in close proximity to one another in what on this channel we call the mosh pit. The close distance ensures that even by spamming random actions, the chance of hitting or being hit increases, thus giving the AI a first taste of the available rewards and punishments. I chose to start with 2 units in each team to give them a better chance at understanding the intricacies of the simulation and how mechanics actually work, before getting them thrown into larger fights where they will get overflooded with information. Once the boys got enough experience of touching swords and their sword being touched, they had to be separated before something naughty happened. Now, the teams are spawned a bit further from each other, which shall teach them be aware of the environment and move towards or away from others. After only 50 hours of training, I got 3 teams of professional choreographers with synchronized dance moves destroying the dance floor. I guess I started this project looking for copper and I found gold. I assumed it must have been due to the drastic increase in the distance between agents, so I tried training them once again from scratch, but gradually increasing the spawner distances so we don't traumatize our AI. Well, that's if we consider that peacefully dancing together means to be traumatized, while ruthless slaughter of countless peers is the embodiment of sanity. This time, the results seemed a bit better, but still far from what I was expecting, so I started debugging the code. Turns out, there was a mistake in the code which caused the agents to get rewards way too high. While the maximum possible reward should have been around 10, I would see reward values of 80, 90, 100, and the number kept rising. The reason was these lines of code where I'm subscribing to these 4 events. When I first initialize the agent, I subscribe to these events and the respective event is triggered every time the soldier performs a successful block, takes or deals damage, and whenever the soldier is minecrafted. So far makes sense, right? Well, apparently, despite the documentation clearly stating that the initialize method is called only once when the agent is first, well, initialized, the truth is this method is called every time the object becomes active. In my case, I would deactivate and activate all soldiers every time the round restarts, meaning the initialize method was called once every round. And considering I never unsubscribed from these events, it meant I kept subscribing to the 4 events again and again with every single iteration. So after about 10 rounds, when a warrior would hit another warrior, instead of receiving 1 reward point, it would be more like 10 points and the value just kept growing. I moved the event subscription from initialize to the awake method, which actually triggers only once, and now that the reward were fixed, it was time for another attempt at training the AI. Honestly, detecting this problem took me way longer than I would like to admit, mainly because of the misleading documentation, but now I know, and you do as well. Do not trust initialize. Awake is the goat. The training was going surprisingly well this time. First few rounds, as expected, were full of confused screeching, wild sword swinging, and very little actual results. But just few hours in, and the AI was showing clear signs of progress, like on round 1131, where the red warrior, after drawing the first blood, gets into a heavy altercation against a very agile green soldier, who swiftly dodges attacks from 2 directions simultaneously, and even manages to eliminate one of the threats. A few seconds later, he gets rid of the other red soldier, winning a 2v1 fight. Unfortunately, the round time ends right before the 2 survivors challenge each other to determine the winner. Another fun round was 1558, where all agents, well, most of them, just sudoku themselves off the map. Silly AI, you forgot there is no escape. You will still get respawned next round. Now that the agents definitely figured out how to move, it was time to set them even more apart and add some more units to each team. Teams will now consist of 10 soldiers each, and the spawners will change position every round. Right off the bat, it seemed to be working rather well, all 3 teams attempting to meet somewhere in the middle and fight. That being said, only 73 rounds in, and we see the red team traversing the entire map just to kick some ass, while Team Green was both fighting Team Blue and the Gravity. Few hundred rounds later, and we already see more organized battles and more precise movement and navigation through the map. By the way, in case this is not your first time on the channel, you must be familiar with the AI Wars series. The series where I train AI armies to fight variations of enemies in challenging environments. The simulation I was using for previous episodes was a whole mess. Spaghetti code, ugly architecture, lots of poorly optimized systems, and much more. This made it extremely difficult to keep adding new stuff and would make it impossible to implement new ideas such as having more than 2 teams, alliances, different game modes, airborne units, and so on. Moreover, converting the simulation into a game would also not be feasible, and AI Wars the game was something I really wanted to make. That is why I have spent the last year developing this new simulation in secret, only posting few sneak peeks on Discord. This project addresses the shortcomings of the initial simulation, unlocking new possibilities such as the multiple team system you are seeing right now. So now, after more than 1 year of development and about 200 hours of training, here are the final results. For the first setup, we'll try a free-for-all fight, but with only one soldier in each team. Based on how they fight, we can decide who we will be rooting for. There will be three rounds for each different setup, and at the end we will see which team scored the most points and who is the winner of this tournament. Alright, we switched from the training mode to the game mode, where we can simulate different scenarios. Let's create three spawners, one for each team, and we will set the team size to 1. That's basically the first prototype of the game, so currently it is only available for free for my Patreons, but once more content is added, I plan on releasing it on Steam as a regular game, so make sure to subscribe so you don't miss it. Once the start button is pressed, the warriors are initialized and the fight ensues. Looks like blue and green crossed their swords, and despite green landing the hit first, blue was already mid-attack, so they both penetrated each other. I tell ya, this is some anime type right here, which makes me wonder how Pogo would look as an anime character. Oh, fuck, not this! Alright, so both blue and green fell defeated, meaning red wins without even fighting. This kind of win did not please the red warrior, and round 2 ends with a mutual destruction. Seems like green minecrafted blue, who then sliced through the red soldier whose attack hit the green warrior. Since all soldiers died, I won't assign any points for this round. Third and last round had the same outcome. After a sweaty battle, these three buffy dudes fell asleep next to each other, which honestly might have been their true goal all along. Alrighty, I don't know about you, but I'm definitely rooting for the green dudes this time. So let's continue with 3 more free-for-all rounds, but this time with 100 soldiers in each team. The reason I have reduced the timescale is to allow me handle hundreds of artificial intelligence agents at decent FPS. I record these big fights with time passing 10 times slower and then just speed up the video by 10 when editing. I learned this during COVID years in university when the courses were remote and the lectures were recorded. A lot of professors would speak very slowly, and I figured out that instead of attending 2-hour classes and falling asleep, I could listen to the recording at twice the speed, thus efficiently saving 1 hour of my expensive time that I could spend on planting lavender in Arcage. Anyways, while yapping, I noticed that the blue and red teams managed to annihilate their own people. Yeah, the game mode is still a bit buggy, but that was an easy fix. Round 1, and the fight immediately splits in 3 directions. Team Green has divided their forces, half trying to hold the blue wave, while the other half is fighting with almost the entire red army. Only few reds are trying to flank the northern side of Team Blue, while the core strength is focused on Team Green, which are putting a hell of a fight, leaving only 3 red warriors alive. Meanwhile, Team Blue, with still lots of warriors alive, finished with the green opponents and started hunting down the red survivors. Round 2 has a similar start and almost identical outcome, Team Blue quickly gaining advantage and eventually surrounding and eliminating their opponents. For round 3, I changed the spawner positions by a bit, however Team Green still tried to handle both teams simultaneously. Despite much better results against both teams this time and almost managing to eliminate 2 entire armies, the Green Warriors were defeated in the end, proving once again that Warriors together strong. The score is now 2 points for Team Red, 2 points for Team Blue, and a total of 0 points for my boys in Team Green. Despite showing a lot of heart, they couldn't score a single point yet, and I doubt this will change in the upcoming stage because now we'll have 3 rounds of unfair alliances. Team Blue and Team Red will now be fighting alongside each other against Team Green. That basically means we have a very unfair setup with 200 warriors on one side versus only 100 on the other side, but hey, life ain't fair either, so it only makes the simulation more realistic. All 3 fights, despite looking really smooth and cool, ended up with the same result of Team Green being slaughtered by the Alliance. What a surprise, right? Well, I don't think it would be fair to give red and blue 3 points each, so how about we just give them 1 point for these 3 victories? And now, let's give the advantage to Team Green. In this last setup, we will increase the number of green soldiers up to 250, so now there are 50 more green warriors than blue and red combined. The fight has spread in a line across the entire map, and despite few red soldiers lacking behind, the alliance still succeeded at fighting off the green opponents. In round 2, a similar strategy can be observed, but this time the green warriors are more serious, holding up for as long as they could before getting overrun once again. No matter what they tried, they would constantly get crushed by the alliance, despite having a numerical advantage. I let them fight for more than 3 rounds, just out of curiosity, but I guess their fate was sealed. Alrighty, looking at the score, I ain't sure who won, but I can definitely say that Team Green lost. That's it for this video. Let me know in the comments what other scenarios should we try in the next episode, and in the meantime, check out this other video I made where I train 1000 AI soldiers to fight a tank. Huge thanks to my Patreon subscribers for supporting the channel. You are the legends. Bye!